Hey yo, what's Gucci? So I made this video as a tutorial, you know, cause I had a couple of my friends be like, "Hey, yo, upload a tutorial," you know, and I was like, "Oh, I will." It's been like 4 years, so I finally did it. Hey, what? Now's the perfect time. Dang, all this stuttering. God dang. Okay, but anyways, this is the tutorial on how I draw. Big thanks to my cousin for allowing me to use her as a, you know, a model for this video. So, shout out to my cousin. You know who you are. Okay, so, but here, let me start the video before I keep rambling. Alright, enjoy. And, alright, tutorial time. Alright, so, what I basically do, my first step I take, every little step I take, Bobby Brown. The first step I take is I look at the picture, okay? You just stare at the picture until you see the shapes that you need to see. What? She? See? So, basically, you're looking at the photo. I see circles. I see squares. I see triangles. I see those geometric shapes, but I had a C in geometry. So, you know, I drew some trapezoids and rectangles and hexagons or whatever. Oh, shape, you see, I use rectangles, I use rectangles, so, you know, that's basically what I do. This is my first initial sketch, so it's like really, a really messy sketch, and I'm just drawing out shapes that I see. What the freak? Okay, anyways, so the next thing I do is I lower the opacity on that layer, and then I go and change to a different color. Since my favorite color green, I put it as green. So this is my second sketch, and it's more refined. As you can see, it's more refined. It's not as messy. It's still sketchy, but not messy as much. No, it's just the basic details that I see in the photo, and then I lower that opacity, and then from here I start coloring. I get my base color, you know, and I start filling in. Now, usually, you know, you see artists do a line art. Not me. I don't know what. I think I watched a tutorial by this other YouTuber whose art, like, I think, what's the, John D, maybe? I don't know. He's a YouTuber. I don't know the person's name. But they did some really cool art, and I looked at a tutorial on how they paint skin and stuff. And they, what they actually did was they just did a sketch layer and then started watercoloring under the sketch. So I guess that's where I got that kind of, you know, inspiration from for how I do my art. I think it's John, I don't know, whatever you do, I'll put it in the description or something. But, and then from there, they just start, you know, putting colors on there. And then people may be asking, "Oh, Savaria, how do you know what color to choose?" I don't. I just look at shadows and the highlights, and I see what color those are. But I try to keep it within the skin tone I'm in, the base color. So I got the base color, and I choose colors that match that base color instead. Now you can see I'm using like a lighter color, like saturate. You mess around with the saturation, you'll see what I mean. Like you want to pick a lighter of that same skin tone or darker of that same skin tone. Some people actually like. Those professional artists be like, "Oh no, nah, we using this color," and they know exactly what color to. I don't. Do not ask me to paint nothing for you in real life, cause I will say no. I do not know how to paint. I painted like several times before, and a man actually bought my paintings, you know, and I made some money. I made like he made me do like 3 paintings, I think, of him and his daughter and all that. And I'm like, never again. Painting's too hard for me. I do not like painting. But did I do it? Did I get that money? Yes, I did. I did. I got paid. He paid me. Pretty sure I made like $300 off of him or something like that. No, those lines. I don't know. It was big money though. And I was like younger at that time. But now I'm older and now I'm doing digital stuff. So yeah, until I get me some art materials, of course. But you know, that's good. And I need to stop rambling. I need to get back to this tutorial. Anyways, right now it looks like I'm just detailing, adding more details to make it pop more. Usually when I'm coloring, I don't think too much about what I'm using. I think more on how to make the photo look just like the person that I'm looking at. You know, I'm drawing what I'm seeing. So that's why you notice me like zooming in, zooming out, looking at the picture, flipping it around, flipping the canvas to see if it matches. And I'm just looking at it and trying to get it as close as I can. See, like right now on the lips, I once was taught that you need to draw the lines of the lips on there. Some people don't do it, some people do. But, you know, I just drew some lines on the lips, you know? Those little skin lines, I guess. The little lines you got on your lips. But I drew those, and it added a little detail into it, you know? And then, guys, your top lip is darker than your bottom. I didn't learn that until, like, last year or such. Because when I used to draw my art style, my own personal art style, it was, like, derived from anime. So, my characters didn't have lips. They didn't really have a nose. Like, especially my early drawings. Oh my god. My early drawings, there was just like, you know, the anime styles where they have the big eyes, that one line for the nose, and a smile. That's how I used to draw my anime characters. Bro, that's how I used to draw the characters all the time. And then I like, come around, will you be moving on? Oh my god. Oh yeah, that's what keeps me singing. I turn it music! Sitting here for hours on end trying to get the freaking drawing.
Can't stand to see nobody kissing, touching her. Ain't nobody loving you the way we were.
That's the MJ.
What good would heaven be?
Man.
If the angels come for me, I'll tell them no.
Carry
so what?
Time.
No. I don't want to leave my baby.
My baby! Baby. What?
Don't you do this to me.
I'm dead. Oh, man.
If the angels come around, just turn them around, my baby. Don't you do this to me.
And it's the chance I'll take. Maybe I'll stay. Heaven can wait. All right, now we're moving on to the eyes. Now, you see I did a lighter color. You know, back in ninth grade, my teacher used to say that I always drew my pupil or my eyes too big or whatever she used to say. She said, my eyes. She said I used to draw them too big. But now that I learned proportions, you know, I see that now. But, you know, they're kind of all right, you know. They're kind of all right. You can notice that one of the eyeballs is bigger than the other. That's why I flipped the camera several times and I kept noticing that. And I didn't fix it until, like, way after. I moved on from that. Basically, what I do is, if I don't, like, I start working on stuff just out the blue. I don't pick and choose what I work on. I just, if I see it and that's on my mind at the moment, I start doing it. See, like, I moved on from the face and went straight to the hand and started just working on that junk. And I filled in what I saw off the image. That's what I did. I don't really, like, stick on one thing. I just work on the whole thing until it looks as much as possible like the person that I'm drawing. So then the eyes, there's a tip. If you get your eyes to look just like the person, then you got it in the bag. See, I had to redo the eyes several times. That's why I just used that little cheat right there, and I duplicated the other eye and put it on the other side and just adjusted it, because I got sick and tired of trying to get the eye right. That I usually don't do that, but like this is like I think this is the first portrait I actually like duplicated the eye on and just flipped it onto the no, this might be the second one. I don't know. But you know, that's basically what I do. And then in a few moments you'll see I'm looking at it and I'm like trying to add depth to the face. See right now, this airbrush, I'm using the airbrush because it's kind of light and airy. So I'm just taking it and, you know, trying to fill in some spots where I see darkness, the shadow app. And then I play with the blend mode. See, it's on hard light right now, but I just play around with the blend mode until I get something that I like. And then mess around with the opacity on the blend modes and stuff. And then I just smoothed it in. Once I add it to the frame, I smooth that junk in. See, the eyes, I did not like the eyes. The eyes went several times. You know, I went over until I got the eyes how I want it to look. God dang. Oh my gosh.
Tell me.
I just went in with some highlights and I went over that. And I just start, I keep tweaking until I get it to look how I want it to look. See, I was messing around with a whole bunch of stuff. You know, see, I don't really have a specific way that I draw. I look at what I draw and I do it. There's no way, I don't know. How do you explain that? What? I forgot to explain that. Okay. Eyeballs. Yeah, we went back to the eyeballs and I was just doing different ways, you know. See, messing with, oh, I forgot to mention the brushes. Watercolor. I was using a watercolor brush and another watercolor brush, but it's watercolor wet. So on the watercolor wet, the colors mix way more than on the regular watercolor brush. So I was using watercolor wet mainly, and it blended all the stuff for me, you know. Of course, I can mess with the blend mode on that, like, but, you know, usually I just keep it on the settings that I have it on, and, you know, that's how I do it. Now, you notice that it looks pretty flat, right? That's because I didn't have any depth inside the drawing. That's why most of the stuff, when I do my speed paints, I kind of, like, any final touches that I do that I didn't record, I just, you know, put it in the photo, and I put the photo at the end to show you. But basically, I felt that it lacked depth. See, I'm getting towards the end right now. Cause I'm working. I get around. Carry on again. Round and round, around it goes. Why call you? Please. Bring a tip, son of tips. That's a tip. Gotta get a tight grip. Don't slip loose. Sending ships is a trip. Love the way she lifts the lips. See me jack up a little twist in her heels because I'm watching. Conversations on the phone to the brick of the. Now we all alone while the lights on. Turn them off. Time to set it off. Get you. Okay, let me stop. Anyways, look, I'm steady trying to get the depth going. See, I had a moonlighting and jump. Like, what you. Yeah. Y'all see me out here on my artist arc. But this is the final, you know, thing. It does look a little bit like it looks like it has a little bit more depth. I tried my hardest on this. And I just want to say. Thank you for watching. Thank you.